As you look up to observe the flags, please remember to look down, watch your step, hold on to the handrails provided for you on the escalator or the center staircase, and take the hands of small children. For your own safety, please do not walk up the escalators. After all, this is your American adventure. Have fun going inside to our theater, ladies and gentlemen. We ask you please to select your row. Walk it across at least two-thirds before sitting down, allowing room for others to join you. Once the curtain goes up and the show begins, there's absolutely no flash photography or videotaping. As a common courtesy toward others around you.
Mark Twain.
America did not exist. 4 centuries of work, bloodshed, loneliness, and fear created this land. We built America, and the process made us Americans. A new breed, rooted in all races, stained and tinted with all colors, a seeming ethnic anarchy. Then, in a little time, we became more alike than we were different. A new society, not great, but fitted by our very faults for greatness. Excuse me, Mr. Twain.
What's that?
Perhaps you recognize those inspiring words from one of America's great writers.
No, Dr. Franklin, I don't recall writing anything like that.
Oh my, of course not. They're from the pen of John Steinbeck, back in the 20th century. Why, it seems he has nearly the same spirit as the founding fathers themselves.
Well, listen to the proud elder statesman.
Mr. Twain, pride is one of our national passions. Even those who overcome it are proud of their humility.
Easy now. I was born modest. Fortunately, wore off. Dr. Franklin is our genuine American antique. I suppose our story begins with you.
Actually, it started long before even my time. It started when dreams and visions of a new world were shrouded in the myths and legends of an old world. Finally, through those early mists of uncertainty, sailed the first great adventurers. This tiny ship is the Mayflower, carrying pilgrims in search of their dream, a dream of religious freedom. So, if you'll pardon an old man's pride, for me, this is the beginning of the American adventure.
There's a land across this ocean I'm waiting to see. A land for these people who dream to be free. So stand by the mainsail, the fierce storms will race. Aloft with ye mates, our King Neptune will face. You'd think that these landlubbers never would last. This cargo of pilgrims, 12 weeks for the mast. It's land ho, me hearties, at last we've arrived. And praise be Let the first bitter winter make evil more dead. They call themselves pilgrims, these poor wretched souls with a dream to be free in the new world their goal.
Yes, far from welcoming the early settlers, this land severely challenged them. It was a struggle for survival that gained but a tiny toehold in a vast, untamed wilderness. In the decades that followed, a new challenge began to emerge. We were growing more and more apart from the mother country. Passion began to govern, and she never governs wisely.
Ah! The British think it's fools we be! If they tax our trade, then our land be next, and soon all else be possessed!
Hear me now! You ask for defense against the French and the Indians. Should you want help, pay for it?
Parliament's colonial policy is both arbitrary and unjust.
That's nonsense. The same tea that cost you 3 shillings a pound costs us 6.
First, we spoke out with our voices. Then, we spoke out with action, with a growing defiance that led to the Boston Tea Party.
Hear ye! Hear ye! By royal proclamation, His Majesty King George the Third, hereby sends...
Look at this! They're closing the harbor!
But surely we can work something out. Our king feels we've wronged him.
Your king, you Tory! Either we cut the ties with England, or we surrender our liberty!
Finally, the time had come to speak with one voice in a declaration of independence.
Good evening, Mr. Jefferson. Have you finished the new draft yet?
Those are new drafts all over the floor, Dr. Franklin. It seems one stroke of this pen brings 2 changes from Congress. I told you John Adams should have written this.
Oh, by his own admission, you can write circles around him.
Mr. Adams has not been prisoner in this loft for 17 days. I shall continue tomorrow.
You must continue now. Thomas, it is difficult to make 13 clocks chime at the same time, but we must carefully justify this separation.
Dr. Franklin, while you slept soundly through the meeting this afternoon, we did manage to justify separation. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain inalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. That to secure these rights, governments...
At 76, my boys, we ever must revere, that every man take his must get up and fight for freedom dear. To hit the flanks of the red coat ranks as Yankee volunteers. Oh, tis a great delight to march and fight, but it's getting tough, I fear.
I shall spend another night. Got shoes, mate. There's not a dozen left when I say that.
Don't tell me, friend. Tell the good general then. Tell him that half his camp has got typhus, smallpox, or dysentery.
And there be not a ration amongst us. Now we can forage for hickory nuts.
Aye, while the English overindulge in all of Philadelphia's fine food and drink.
Tis a strange war we shoulder, George Washington. Congress sleeps warmly in York.
And the British party in Philadelphia.
And we freeze or starve to death here in Valley Forge.
The plains of Valley Forge, my boys, forever we must hail. We fight the cold with rice and nothing as the lobster bites regale. The time will come when they'll be on the run and their ships will homeward sail.
Thank you.
our greatest dream. 13 very different colonies became the United States of America. And we were free to become an entire nation of dreamers and doers.
Westward bound, Dr. Franklin, to new frontiers.
To the age of Samuel Langhorne Clemens.
Well, I like to think Mark Twain was part of all that. Sir, Dr. Franklin, you founding fathers gave us a pretty good start, don't you know? We still had some things to learn the hard way. Seems a whole bunch of folks found out we the people didn't yet mean all the people. Folks like Frederick Douglass.
Even amidst the cricket song here along Mark Twain's beloved Mississippi, I hear the noise of change and the crack of the whip. Yet, there is hope. Hope born from the words of Harriet Beecher Stowe. Uncle Tom's Cabin is giving our nation a key, which can unlock the slave prison to millions. Anti-slavery is no longer a thing to be prevented. It is grown too abundant to be snuffed out.
Troublemakers like Douglass got us into this mess.
We only wanted freedom, not war.
Well, listen to my abolitionist brother.
What?
Pa, he's gonna make a real good Philly Yank.
We got a good cause, Johnny Grimm.
Quiet, both of you. You're gonna ruin Ma's birthday.
No, no. Ain't nothing gonna ruin today. We're all together. That's what counts. Now, you go ahead, Mr. Brady.
All right, everybody. Hold real still now.
Brothers.
We're the one country around us, and one government for all. From where the sun now stands, I will fight no more. Forever. The wisdom of the great Chief Joseph reminded us once again of our long, painful journey through the frontiers of human liberty.
Franklin's Philadelphia again. We're 100 years old today. We came a long way in that first century. But like Susan B. Anthony, we're still speaking out.
And why shouldn't we, Mr. Twigg?
As Tom Edison says, discontent is the first necessity of progress.
Edison? Afraid I don't place a name.
Edison's that young phonograph inventor. Why, this great hall is filled with new inventions. There's Otis Elevator, Corliss magnificent steam engines.
And don't forget me, telephone, the true hallmark of progress.
Aha! Behold the proud Scots.
That's right. Carnegie Steel built this place.
Aye, and it'll soon build a new concert hall for New York.
Oh, Carnegie Hall, eh? It'll never last. Donating libraries. Andy, that's a grand idea.
It's an age for grand ideas.
An era for innovation.
A dawn for new awareness.
A time to challenge the frontiers of a new century.
The winds of change. But our America, the beautiful, she was changing too. We needed people like Teddy Roosevelt and an outspoken naturalist, John Muir, to get our attention.
Beautiful. Bully beautiful. Those falls are magnificent.
Aye, Mr. President. But it won't last if the timber thieves have their way.
John, you may be right, but the country's growth is putting a tremendous demand on our resources.
Any fool can destroy trees. Why, for more than 3,000 years, God has cared for our giant sequoias, saved them from drought, disease, avalanches, and floods. But he cannot save them from fools.
Now, John, you know I can't ask lumbering to stop completely.
All I ask is that we stop massive destruction. What will our children inherit? Seedlings?
Of course not. I realize we're not building this country for a generation alone. I know we've got to expand our parks.
Then start it here and now. Make this valley a part of Yosemite National Park.
Well, I guess we needed those national parks. Seems the simple life of my day was slipping away. Ready or not, we were soon thrust into the hectic role of a world leader and into the war to end all wars.
three grueling non-stop hours after his departure from New York, Captain Charles Augustus Lindbergh successfully landed his Spirit of St. Louis in Paris last week. Lucky Lindy's solo flight across the Atlantic has certainly placed him among the greatest in a long line of American pioneers.
Today, October 29th, 1929, Wall Street became America's greatest wall of rubble. This stock market crash has tarnished the golden dreams of millions.
Once I built a tower to the sun, brick and rivet and lime. Once I built a tower, now it's done. Brother, can you spare a dime?
Spare a dime? Sure. Buy four of my apples, and I'll loan you back the 10 cents.
Hey, Sam, I heard tell there's New York millionaires are selling apples, too.
You mean ex-millionaires, don't you?
Hey, looks like the storm is finally letting up. Well, maybe the Sunday drivers will come out hunting for gas.
Ain't many folks will pay no 18 cents a gallon.
Hey, listen, fellas. Old FDR's been in Auburn.
Frankly and boldly, this great nation will endure as it has endured, will revive, and will prosper. So first of all, let me assert my firm belief that the only thing we have to fear is fear itself.
Sure hope he's right. Folks could use a little prosperity around these parts.
Yes, sir. Before this depression, we sure had enjoyed special blessings.
Hold it.
But you it seems to me that we was a mighty cocky nation.
We'd begun to believe that the height of civilization was an automobile, a radio, and a bathtub. Of course, now we're a whole lot smarter. Now, Congress wants to trim down the Navy, so it'll fit into the bathtub, too. You know, it seems to me like we're the only nation in the world that waits till we get into a war before we start getting ready for it.
Yesterday, December 7th, 1941, the peace of the Lord of Kinsley, United States of America was suddenly and deliberately attacked.
Oh,
you can do for your country. My fellow citizens of the world, ask not what America will do for you, but what together we can do for the freedom of man.
I have a dream this afternoon that the brotherhood of man will become a reality in this state, with this state.
Down 2.5,
forward, just into the right low. Contact light. Okay, engine stop. We copy it down, Eagle. Tranquility Base here. The Eagle has landed. Restless one in a world of change, keeping dreams alive.
And meaning of America. To everyone a chance, believed Thomas Wolfe. To all people, regardless of their birth, the right to live, to work, to be themselves, and to become whatever their visions can combine to make them. This is the promise of America. Mr. Duane, it is easy to see, hard to foresee, but I foresee the American adventure to continue a long, long time.
America, you must stay dreaming now, dreaming the promise now of your pioneers. America, keep on flying now, keep your spirit free, facing new frontiers.
I know. 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 I know.